G'day, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. Welcome to this video in the free math worksheet series. This week's topic is one of the most challenging that I've talked about in this series. It's a topic involving common fractions, and we're going to be converting them to decimals via looking at how many hundredths they're equal to. So the worksheets come from this book entitled Classroom Professor Gadgets Equivalent Fractions. So the gadgets is a set of software that we have available, but the worksheets are available separately or together with the software. And the idea is that we're giving the students tools to understand the fractions. I don't know how you feel about it, but I for one am a little bit tired of exercises to help students find answers in a sort of mechanical way without any thinking at all, without any conceptual development, without understanding what the numbers mean or what the fractions are. Just simply do this, do this, do this, do this. Oh, look, magical, there's the answer. So I think that is a terrible way to teach mathematics, and I'd rather it was never taught that way, ever. Anyway, don't have time to go on and on about it, but our approach is to help students understand the size of the numbers, understand the connections, and lead them, if possible, to discover the relationships. So I'm not trying to pedantically say, here it is, follow this, this is a method, blah, blah, blah. There's plenty of time for the method down the track, but early on, sorry, that's an Australian expression, further on in the student's development, there'll be time to say, now you understand it, here's a method, and we'll practice the method and everybody will get the method. But we shouldn't start with the method at the beginning. All right. So further development of that idea, I'll put into a PD course about teaching fractions. So that's for a time in the future. So the worksheets themselves, there are four worksheets in the set as usual. Let me put that closer to the camera. They look a lot like that. So there's a large example in the middle, and we've called this an investigation. So as I just said, we want the students to effectively discover the relationship rather than being told what it is. So this comes after looking at equivalent fractions between different common fractions. So we've, in the book and with the software, we can help students understand that a half is equal to 3/6 or 4/8 or 5/10 and so on. Not because we say so, not because we've got some mechanical method to find it, but because we're looking at the pictures. And the software does this by showing two different diagrams, and you can see that they're both the same and they have different symbols and so on. But we're going to extend that now and look at hundredths. So let's look at a fraction. And in the first worksheet, you'll see that we have 3/4 as a fraction, and we're going to convert that into hundredths. So what we want the students to do is to work out what equivalent fraction is there for 3/4 where the denominator is 100. Or in other words, how many hundredths are the same as 3/4. Now, I'm not going to try and draw hundredths on the board. That's one of the beauties of the software, that it will show you hundredths, you know, in a blink, because the software is designed to do that. But if we just use a physical model like this and say, can you think about how many hundredths there would be? If there were 100 pieces, well, let's say, look at this one. If that was divided into 100 equal pieces called hundredths, how many of those 100 pieces would fit on top of those three there? So the student should be able to see that if we divided this 100 into 4 equal parts, a fourth or a quarter of 100 is 25, so we would have 25 hundredths that would be equal to this quarter or fourth, and another 25 here and another 25 there. Sorry, I said 3/4 several times earlier. That's what we call it in Australia and the UK and British Commonwealth countries. I know in the US you call them fourths, so quarters or fourths. They're synonyms, mean the same thing. All right, so we're going to be able to help our students see that a fourth or a quarter is 25 hundredths. If we've got 3/4, it looks like this. We use a whole range of resources and exercises and questions for the students. Let me use a different color. Of course, the answer here is going to be 75. You'll note I haven't talked about a method for multiplying and dividing and working that out. We'll do that, as I said, later on in the students' development. When your students are ready for that, then obviously we'll talk about the fact that these two numbers have both been multiplied by the same number. And in this case, of course, it's 25. But I'd immediately say, why 25? Where does that come from? And refer back to this model here. As I said, if we saw this as 100, that would have 25 pieces, 25 hundredths, making up the fourth or quarter. All right, so that's not too difficult, relatively easy. We can help the students see that if we're making an equivalent fraction in hundredths, using a starting fraction like fourths or quarters, it's not too difficult, mainly because 4 is a factor of 100, or we can divide 100 by 4. What would we have, however, if we had 1/3? And that's the next exercise on the worksheet. So that's the one that's an investigation here in the middle of the page with the large circles. 1/3 on the left-hand side, and then a diagram in the worksheet showing 100 pieces. How many hundredths are there going to be? Now, I would prefer to take a bit longer. Obviously, we don't have a lot of time on the video, and on the worksheet, we get to this point pretty quickly. But you might want to do more exercises thinking about different fractions equal to hundredths before you get to the 1/3 example. Obviously, this is a tricky example, and the hardest thing about it is we can't divide 100 by 3 evenly. We'll get some, you know, irregular sort of answer. But this is what we're trying to do. We're trying to say 1/3 equals how many hundredths. You'll recognize straight away that equal sign isn't going to help us because we don't have an answer up here, or at least we don't have a whole number answer. So we're actually going to use a different symbol, and we think this is appropriate. Now, you'll have to look at your curriculum to see when students are ready for the symbol approximately equal to. But in this context, this is exactly the symbol that we need. It's not going to be an exact number. I realize if you're thinking, well, we could write 33 and 1/3. Yes, I know we could, but we're trying to find a whole number that's close. So, you know, bear with me. So we're going to say 1/3 is around about how many, using the diagram on the worksheet, because we've got all the 100 pieces actually marked. There it is on the worksheet here. We could invite our students to color in the right number that they think. So, you know, color in as many as you need to in order to have it equal the 1/3. And of course, they'll be coloring in 33. They should be able to see 33 is the closest, 34 is too big, and so on. We could talk about the fact that when it was fourths, we could divide the 100 by 4 to find out there were 25. We can try dividing 100 by 3. So there's a number of ways of getting to the answer. But what we're going to say is this is approximately equal to 33. With a little bit more discussion, with more thinking on the part of the students, and again, not because you've told them the answer, but because they've had a chance to think, they might be able to see that there's actually 1/3 more than that. Okay, now the next step, and it's the same on each of these worksheets this week, we're going to write that down as a decimal fraction. So we'll write 1/3 again equals 0. And of course, again, this is where it gets tricky. I hope you can see that what we're trying to do here is develop thinking and understanding, as I've already said several times, rather than some mechanical method. So we're not going to immediately say, oh, let's do some division and work out the answer. We're not going to jump to a calculator. I know a calculator will give us the answer, but we want to understand where that answer comes from. So what we're going to do here is say, well, this is 33 hundredths. It's approximately. What does 33 hundredths look like if we write it as a decimal? And again, we should change this symbol to an approximately equal sign as we have in the worksheet, and we can see 1/3 is approximately equal to 0.33. Now, that's not the exact answer. There's a lot more that we could talk about, and when students are older, because we think this is probably around about, let's say, now I'm guessing here, you'd have to check the curriculum, grade 5, year 6, something like that, and older. We don't have to get into the heavy detail of what it is exactly. We're trying to introduce this as an approximation. The other thing to say here is that's close enough for most everyday purposes. If we're dividing by 3 and we say, well, that's 33 hundredths, that's pretty well close enough for what we need. Okay, so there are more exercises like this. It's a different style of worksheet. So a lot of the other worksheets that I've talked about have a page full of exercises, and what we're trying to develop there is fluency and speed and memorization and, you know, getting the answers right quickly. And so we have the 10 minutes a day series for students to be timed on their work. This is not a timed worksheet. This will take quite a bit of discussion and thinking and talking and playing with ideas. It would be the sort of thing you could do with a group of students and have them investigate it together. And you can, you know, tweak the question and add different examples and that sort of thing. So a little bit different, a little bit challenging for the students. I'd love to hear your feedback if you'd like to let me know what you think. But that's it for this week, and I'll talk to you next time.